Praise the Lord, dear brothers and sisters. It gives me great joy to bring to you a short message from Psalm 23, the Good Shepherd. This is an all-time favorite of people, and this psalm is used in the time of grief to bring comfort for people. This psalm is written by King David, and his experiences as a shepherd boy has been brought into this psalm, and he's attributing God, Jehovah God, as a great shepherd. Verse 1, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. Our God is a self-existent God, and since our God is all-powerful, present everywhere, and He knows everything, people who trust in this God will never be in want. You may be an ordinary person, and I may be an ordinary person. You may be a leader, and you may be a part of the family, but for all our needs as individuals, as family, and as a community, this Jehovah God is sufficient for all our needs. And then David talks about the great blessings this shepherd gives to us from verse 2. What are the great blessings this shepherd does to the people who love him? First of all, he makes me lie down in green pastures, talks about food that the shepherd provides. He leads me beside quiet waters, talks about food and water. It can also talk about spiritual food, and spiritual food comes to us from the Word of God. Friends, God is able to provide to us our physical food, and more importantly for our soul, God provides us spiritual food, and that is found in the Word of God. Do you have a time every day, every moment of your life, where you go to the still waters of the Word of God and you are refreshed by it? What happens when we are fed by God? In verse 3, it says, He restores my soul. He brings us into times of revival, refreshing. In this world, we go through tough times. We go through difficulties. And we find refreshing only in the presence of God. And then David says that this shepherd guides me in the path of righteousness. Just like God led the children of Israel from Egypt all the way in the wilderness to the promised land for decades, God was faithful, God was committed to guide them. God goes before us and He guides us. And what is the path of righteousness? There are times when we stray away from God, when there is a habit that comes or wrong friendship that comes, or when we sin voluntarily. God is faithful to come to us, correct us, and when we confess our sins, He will forgive and He will lead us back into the path of righteousness. Then David says, even though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I will fear no evil. David says that as human beings, we will all die one day. If coming of the Lord is delayed, all of us will have to go through the valley of shadow of death. Like a sheep that is not afraid of wild animals hiding in the valleys, because the shepherd takes care of the sheep, our God will take care of us when we go through the valley of death. Death is very dreadful, and it is very painful to see the death of a loved one. If you have seen the death of a loved one, you know what is that valley of shadow of death. And sometimes we may have to face death if the coming of the Lord is delayed. David says, even if I die, I will not be afraid because my God is with me. Because to be absent in the body is to be present with the Lord. Death is a doorway to God's presence. And that's why, as long as my shepherd is with me, life or death, I will be happy, I will be content in my God. And then he says, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Rod and staff are the equipments or the tools of a shepherd used to protect, to feed, to guide, and to lead and bring back stray sheep back to the pen. So, David says that my God has all power in His capacity. He's all powerful to take care of me well. Friends, when you have Jesus or God as your shepherd, He is all sufficient to take care of us. Verse 5, you prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. We don't have to be looking for a time where all our enemies are defeated. The greatest enemy we face is Satan, and sometimes Satan uses people to work against us. So you don't have to look for a time when all the problems are solved and then you can be happy. No, we rejoice always. Why? Even when we have enemies, even when people are working against us, God prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. So I can rejoice like a king preparing a banquet for his people. I can rejoice in my God who is my great shepherd. You anointeth my head with oil, and my cup overflows. David was anointed king at a very young age, but for many years he never became king. He went through many difficulties, ran away from King Saul, went into the Philistine camp, acted as a madman. But God, who promised, was faithful to fulfill his promise. And at the right time, David became king. So likewise, all the promises of God will be fulfilled in your life. You may see your circumstances and think that nothing is happening, but God is faithful to fulfill all your promises. And my cup overflows. There were times in David's life that he needed food and food was not given. He needed security, but there was nobody to protect him. He needed clothes and probably he did not have sufficient clothes. But now, as a king, David is looking back and telling, I have everything that I need because my God has provided for me. Isn't it true for you, my dear friends? God has provided all your needs. Look back and see how much of provision we have experienced from God. Surely our cup overflows. Verse 6, surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life. The sheep is followed by the shepherd to protect the sheep from enemies. And David says, my God is not only leading me from the front, he is following me from behind. Goodness and love. Who is love? God is love. Who is good? God is good. God follows us all the days of my life. Until our death and all through eternity, we have God following us. Why should you be afraid? And then David says, I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. David longed to dwell in the house of the Lord, in the temple. But in the Old Testament temple, nobody can stay. Non-Levite can stay. And only the Levites, the priests who do ministry at the temple, can stay in the temple. But David longed to be in the presence of God. David could not constantly dwell in the presence of God in the Old Testament setup. But in the New Testament, you and I can always dwell in the presence of God. Why? Because in John chapter 10 verse 11, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. Jesus Christ is that good shepherd. He came as a son of God in flesh, lived and died for no fault of his. He died in your place and he rose again, promising that he will come back again to establish his kingdom. And if you become a child of God by receiving him into your life, you will get all the blessings of this good shepherd, spiritual blessings, as well as he will meet the need of your day-to-day life. May God give you the grace to hold on if you're going through a tough time to the promises of this good shepherd and you find your rest and providence in the presence of this Almighty God. God richly bless you.